Sharat built a beautiful sand castle on the beach as his parents watched from a distance. His sister Anandi helped him to decorate it with seashells. The castle had three towers and high walls. At the horizon, the setting sun looked like a glowing golden ball. The sun rays turned everything golden and the waves lashing on the shore touched their feet. Manohar and Kalyani had been planning this trip to Goa for 2 years with their children, Sharat and Anandi. This was the family's first holiday on a sea beach. The sun-kissed beaches, rows of coconut trees along them, and the vast Arabian Sea make Goa a perfect holiday spot. They could see some children playing on the Baga beach, while some tourists were sunbathing. A few people were swimming in the sea. Anandi suddenly pulled Sharat's t-shirt and said,
"Look, those two boats are coming towards the shore. They are moving up and down on the waves."
Sharat and Kalyani turned towards the boats. Manohar smiled.
"Those are fishermen who go out in their boats to catch fish. They cast nets to catch crabs, prawns, lobsters and various kinds of fishes. They come back and sell them."
Anandi looked excited.
"Okay, father, which places will we visit tomorrow?"
Manohar said,
"We will visit Anjuna, Kandolim and Kalangut beaches tomorrow. We will also visit some churches. We will go to the Basilica of Bom Jesus in Old Goa and the Church of Saint Francis of Assisi. Let us go back to the hotel and take some rest now."
Later, the family had a quiet dinner at the hotel. They enjoyed the traditional food of Goa, fish curry, rice and arroz dosa. After dinner, they went back to their room. Sharat and Anandi sat next to their parents on the bed before going to sleep. Sharat asked curiously,
"Father, tell us more about Goa."
Manohar said,
"Goa is India's smallest state in terms of area and the fourth smallest in terms of population. It is located on the western coast of India, along the Arabian Sea. It is renowned for its beautiful beaches. Tourists from all over India and other countries flock here for an unforgettable experience. Panaji is the capital of Goa. The other important city is Margao. Isn't all this interesting?"
The children nodded.
"Yes, father."
Anandi listened keenly as Kalyani further added, "This place is rich in flora and fauna as it is located on the Western Ghats range. You will be surprised to know that Goa has a literacy rate of 87%. Here most of the men and women are literate. Konkani is the official language here. Marathi, Hindi and Portuguese are also spoken by the people. So you can learn Konkani here, children." Sharat and Anandi looked confused.
"But how can we learn it in 2 days?
Kalyani said. "I was not serious. I know it is impossible in 2 days. Now go off to sleep. We have to visit many places tomorrow." Next day, the family hired a cab and visited the Basilica of Bom Jesus in Old Goa. Sharat said to his father,
"Why do so many people come here?"
Manohar patiently answered,
"Well, it holds the mortal remains of Saint Francis Xavier, regarded as the patron saint of Goa."
They lit candles and also visited the Church of Saint Francis of Assisi. By afternoon, they reached the Kalangut beach. They took a dip in the sea and the children splashed water on each other. Later, they had some fried fish and sana from a shack. They also visited the Kandolim beach. They were amazed to see tourists enjoying water sports like water surfing, water skiing and scuba diving at the Sinkurim beach. Manohar and Kalyani enjoyed parasailing. Sharat and Anandi clapped when their parents were lifted up in the air. When they landed, the children went on water scooters. It was like riding motorbikes on the sea. They were very happy. On their way back to the hotel, they saw groups of youngsters playing football on the beaches and in open grounds. Manohar said,
"Football is a popular sport in Goa. The main football stadium is the Nehru Stadium in Margao. Many cricket matches are also played there. I also like to play football and cricket,"
chirped Sharat. They also visited Fort Agoda before returning to their hotel. They bought keychains and decoration pieces made of seashells as souvenirs. At night, the bags were packed before they went to bed. Kalyani said, "Good night. Tomorrow we will be back home." Everyone smiled and said,
"Yes."
Manohar said,
"Goans are cheerful and friendly people. We came to know a lot about the people and culture of Goa. We should respect all this. I love this place."